Hi dears, welcome to our today's class. For last few classes, we have discussed about the characteristics of acids. The substances which have sour taste and changes blue litmus red are called acids. When acids react with metals, hydrogen gas is produced. And when it reacts with carbonate, carbon dioxide gas is formed, which helps to extinguish fire. Today we are going to see the characteristics of alkali. In the beginning of this chapter, you studied how to make a blue hibiscus paper. Dip this blue hibiscus paper into an acid. What do you see? Yes, it will turn red. Then dry them. Now you got a red colored hibiscus paper. Let's conduct an experiment with this red colored hibiscus paper with some substances. First one, lime water. When we dip red hibiscus paper in lime water, it turned to blue color. Repeat this experiment using water. What do you see? Yes, there is no change except the hibiscus paper becomes wet. Next one is with soap solution. In it, you can see that the red colored hibiscus paper turned to blue as seen in lime water. The last one, salt solution. In salt solution, there is no color change. So, what are the liquids in which red hibiscus turns blue in color? Yes, in substances like lime water, soap solution, etc., the red hibiscus paper or red litmus paper turned to blue. And these substances are called alkalis. Generally, alkalines have a bitter taste and they are slimy. Let's see the alkalis used in laboratory. Calcium hydroxide. It is formed when quicklime is mixed with water. Second one, sodium hydroxide solution. Caustic soda. Third one, potassium hydroxide solution. Caustic potash. Fourth one, ammonium hydroxide solution. Liquor ammonia dissolved in water is ammonium hydroxide solution. So far, we have discussed about hibiscus paper and litmus paper in which they are used to distinguish between acids and alkalis. We use turmeric, beetroot, red cabbage, etc. to distinguish acids and alkalis. Each of these papers shows different colors in acids and alkalis. What could be the reason for red color appearing on clothes when turmeric stain on them is washed with soap? Yes, soap is an alkali. Turmeric gives red color with alkali. So it is clear that turmeric is an indicator which helps to distinguish alkali. Indicators. Indicators are substances that helps us to distinguish between acids and alkalis through color change. Parts of plants like turmeric, hibiscus, beetroot, etc. can be used as indicators. Litmus paper is an indicator used in laboratory. Let's see some indicators that are used in laboratory. First one, phenolphthalein. Take small quantities of acid and alkali in two separate beakers. Add 2 drops of phenolphthalein to each beaker. Do you see any color change? Here, there is no color change in the beaker that contains acid. But the beaker containing alkali changed its color to pink. Repeat this experiment using methyl orange instead of phenolphthalein. methyl orange is an orange colored solution. Now we are going to see what happens when methyl orange is added on acid. Observe the color change. Yes, the color changes to pale pink. In an acidic medium, the color of the indicator methyl orange is pale pink. Now let's check the color of methyl orange in alkaline solution. Look at the color change. In alkaline solution, it turned to pale yellow. Once again, when phenolphthalein is added to the acid, it doesn't change its color. But in alkali, it turned to pink. Phenolphthalein is not used to determine acid. Methyl orange is used to test both acid and alkali. It shows a pale pink in acid and pale yellow in alkali. Universal indicator. Universal indicator is the mixture of different indicators depending on the strength of acidic and alkaline nature of the solution. Universal indicator gives different colors. These colors can be compared with the color chart which is affixed outside the bottle. Dear students, let's conclude today's session. There is an activity for you. Which are the indicators used to detect acid and which are the indicators used to detect alkali? Try it. See you again. Thank you.